Welcome to the Matrix. Prime style with your boy. Let's get it.
Game that you know it can be.
I'm not going to speak for myself. I'm going to speak for the community.
Okay.
Because I'm all about the community. I'm not about myself. I'm for the community and the community as a whole. And the community says that, listen to us. You have to listen to the community. If you listen to the community, you're going to get everybody back. It won't be all this, the stuff that we hear. You know, it won't be that. You know, people will actually see the game the way it's always intended to be. See, people fail to realize is that live was always the first. Live has been the top. I don't want to stray off your question, but it's always been there, you know. But for it to get back, the community has to be heard. And the community, we're very, very passionate. The live community is very, very passionate. We're so passionate that, you know, sometimes we get the individuals that can be a little bit extreme. They do go over the top.
right.
But at the same time, you know, it's all, you know, about the community. Now, if you just want to, just hear the community out, because, you know, we know what needs to be back into our game. It's the community, you know, and what we say. And from what I've been seeing, a lot of stuff in the community, they have tons of great suggestions. I mean, the suggestions is so overwhelming that I see the stuff that I get forward to, and a lot of people they bring forth to me, and to the NRVC as well, you know. And it's like it's amazing on what, you know, what they say and what they bring to the table. So like I say, the community is the main thing.
Let me ask you a question on that. So I got asked this the other day, and it was somebody asked me, what is the most craziest suggestion that the community has asked me to give to developers? And I'm going to ask you that question. What is the craziest suggestion you've heard from somebody in the community? Like somebody that's passionate about, they want to see Velcro shoes in the game. What's that one thing that you like? You're like, huh? Okay, if that's what you want. Well, let me ask you this. Do you get caught up with the people who are all about the apparel? Because I know for myself, I get that all the time. You know, oh, we need, you know, more throwback uniforms. We need the Nike combat uniforms in Madden. We need, you know, this uniform is wrong. It should have a blue stripe. And, you know, and I listen to everybody. And it's hard for me because I'm like, I know there's more pressing issues in Madden that I'm trying to get to developers, but I have to give them that too. I have to tell them, hey, look, I had this dude say that this uniform is wrong and that he would like to see Nike combat uniforms. Do you struggle with that per se? And what do you tell the community when they come to you with that stuff? I know you listen, but I mean, do you try to stress the importance of gameplay, defense, signature moves over apparel, shoes?
What I tell everybody in the community, this is what I say, is that apparel is a good thing because it is part of the game of basketball, because you want to look good on the court. Don't get me wrong. So, you know, a lot of people do come with that. But when I tell people is that, you know, we want to focus more on just apparel. We want to focus on the actual fundamentals of basketball. We want to focus on the actual, you know, what was the gameplay and what needs to be brought forward, you know, to the game. That's what I actually tell a lot of people, you know. And I also tell people that, you know, the dev team, they have a direction. You know, right. We know what that direction is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, well, I do anyway. I know what that direction is. It's just that, will the community be patient enough
to see it happen? Yeah,
exactly.
I agree. I get that all the time. I think sometimes the community loses focus over how little a cycle is. You know, a cycle is not a full year. You know, these guys only have but so many months to get these new things in, and they have a vision, but they can't get everything into the next version of the game. Talk to me real quick about Ultimate Team. Are you big into Ultimate Team? See, I'm not big into Mutt. I'm not big into Madden Ultimate Team, but I have to recognize it because so many people are. How is Lut for NBA Live?
All right. I'm going to break it down for you real quick. I just started getting into the Lut.
Okay.
Actually, I like it.
Okay.
I really like it. It's fun. I do. I like it. And the way it's incorporated. And actually, you know, the good thing about the Lut is that it's a very, very good mode. It's a very good feature. And to be honest with you, whatchamacallit, one of the devs, and I had talked to him, is Yuri. And he told me, because we was, you know, talking about trying to incorporate some new things in the modes, he told me to check out Madden. And I only, like I say, I had the EA access, and I played Madden. But I didn't play Madden for a long time. So I played Madden. And I played, the first time I played Madden, I only played like for maybe 3-4 hours. So I got back on it. So I said, you know what, he told me to go ahead and get back on it. When I got back on the Madden, I looked, and I was like, you know what? And then everybody was in my ear. So I went in. I went out and checked out the Mutt. I was just like, wow, this needs to come over the Live. The way it's incorporated. Mm-hmm. The way they do it. Mm-hmm. If this comes over the Live like this, we got something going here.
Mm-hmm.
Because the Lut is already good. It just needs that little push.
Right.
And the implementations of how the Mutt is in Madden, they bring that over too. Wow. It's fantastic because the cards and everything is already good the way they have everything set up because it's fun. A lot of individuals just don't know how to start it off. You know, just give a quick. If y'all starting the Lut, what you want to do is that you want to get your cards. You're going to get a couple of cards. You're going to get them, okay? But if you know players and your knowledge of players is up to par and you know certain players, what you want to do first is that before you start is that you want to go into the actual store to see what people have actually put up to see if you can actually buy them. If mm-hmm. you got extra cards, you can actually sell those, get some coins for yourself. You don't necessarily have to buy the cards for yourself. Then you can build you up a nice, decent team to start yourself out with. I tell people this, if you're going to start out in the Lut, to get yourself going so you can get some better players. Don't play the head-to-head yet.
You're right, right.
Play the head at first with the players that you have.
Crushed.
You're
yeah.
I'm just letting you know that right now. So play some of the actual, you know, the activities and some of the objectives first
mm-hmm.
with the team, and then you build your players up. And you'll see how dramatically how your money raises up from the players that you get. You'll be amazed on what you get. Because like I said, you can sell your contracts. You can sell the practice jerseys. You can sell the actual arenas that you actually earn. You can actually go in the store and see if you can sell some of the players that you got. You can put them for a bid. You can do that. It's very fun and very intriguing. So, you know, the Lut has a lot of stuff. The way they got the Lut now is fine to me. I enjoy it. I love it. It's a great feature. But with how they incorporate it in detail, like they do in Madden with the Mutt and the way they do it, and they incorporate it into a basketball style, oh, wow. It's woo!
All right, let's talk about another mode in Live, and there's actually two more modes I want to talk about real quick. And before we get to the Live run, let's talk about the Rising Star. I felt like me personally the Rising Star was a little lackluster, but what did you think about the Rising Star, and what do you feel like the community wants to see that mode, you know, evolve?
I just started. I didn't play the Rising Star all like that. I just really started getting into the Rising Star. Okay. And when I played it, there's some things that could be a little bit, that can be incorporated into that mode. Because it's a little bit too easy.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want to make trying to achieve objectives or to get somewhere easy, because that's not how it is in the NBA. It's but you want to make it to the point where you that you're earning what you're getting.
Right.
So, when you play that mode, when you first start out, you have your my player that's already created. But once you get in, you only get one game. So they evaluate you over one game. I was really kind of, no, you don't want to do that. Because if your player is already, well, mine is already high. So when I did my Rising Star, I didn't get subbed out the game. They kept me in.
Right.
But if your player is a little bit low, they take you out.
Yeah.
You know, so I was actually the second best player on my team because my player was already up there.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kept me in. But when it evaluated me, I did all the right stuff in the game because I know me.
Right.
But if you're approaching the game, you got to do the little things to incorporate to make your player, you know, so they can even judge you better. But I feel they can go a little bit more. Like, you know, you're not supposed to get judged from one game. You should be able to play multiple games, maybe two or three. You need to get into a training facility, you know, like go to the, you know, a training facility, do a workout,
right.
You know, do like a little seminar, you know, like a tryout, a workout.
Right.
So you should be able to do that because there's a lot of things that you need to do before you can get to the pros or even before you can get to the draft. So there's a lot of things that you got to do in the Rising Star, in the actual NBA before you can actually go to the next level. You know, just from what I know from what I've started playing the Rising Star on, there are certain things that can be incorporated because, like I say, I talk about it with my team all the time. So, you know, they do a little bit more because they play the Rising Star more. And that's the reason why I started playing it a little bit more. And I saw what I actually be incorporated more. And I see what they're talking about. But all in all, you know, it plays good. I mean, it's a fun mode. It's not bad at all.
Mm-hmm.
You know, when I got drafted, which I'm drafted now, I got drafted by the Miami Heat.
Okay.
So, I was the 10th overall pick. So, so I got drafted by the Miami Heat. And the way they do it, it's real good. So I don't see nothing really wrong with it. It's just a little bit of things that could be incorporated with it. And they say it's like, you know, the AI or the, you know, the intelligence of the game. When they need to sub people, they keep you out, they sub you in at the end of the game. You know, it's like little mishaps that I saw. The only reason why I know that because I saw one of my teammates on his stream that he was doing, and I saw what he was actually doing. I was like, what? No. So you should be able to, you know, they should tweak that out with the AI in that aspect. Well, all in all, I would give the Rising Star about a 70%.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, just for starting out. You can incorporate new stuff with it.
Right. I'm Ryan Parks says in the chat, Rising Star needs a lot more depth to keep the user engaged. I think that's something that people compare it to 2K and you know, the My Player. And we'll talk about that in a minute, but let's talk about Live Run and Pro-Am. Like, that was a big addition to the NBA Live, and it's been great. I mean, I love playing you know, Live Run. What is your take on Live Run, and give me a couple of suggestions you feel Live Run could use to make that mode even better, even though I think it's great right now.
Wow. I'm thank God you did this because we just did. On the NLVC, we just did the show on the program on the elaborations of this.
Okay.
We just did it. What we feel is that, I'll give you my first thing. We feel that a lot of people did get confused on what the program actually was and what the live run is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. A lot of people don't know what program actually is. Program means professional and the AM means the amateur. Okay.
Right.
And all these players that come out, they come out to the event is an actual tournament.
Right.
So you got the Goodman League and you got the Drew League. And you already got the Dot. That is your pro-am.
Mm-hmm.
And they come to these. So you have certain individuals, you have certain pro athletes that come out, they're joining, they be in the tournament. And that's in the summer league. That's what they do. But how we feel is that the live run and the pro-am need to be separate. Because the live run is not part of the pro-am. The
right.
pro-am is an actual tournament.
Right.
The live run should be something where it should be like a pickup game or a street ball aspect, okay?
Okay.
Because a lot of people thought live run was actually pro-am.
Right.
And live run is not pro-am. Pro-am is actual tournament, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Whereas a 5-on-5 environment where, you know, the Goodman League is like, the Goodman is where you have a lot of high school cats, you know, you got the amateurs and everything, and they'd be in a tournament in that. With the Drew League, that's based in Los Angeles, okay, that's where it was actually based at, and that's where it started, okay? You know, they play those tournaments, and then they come together, and they, you know, they, you know, it's huge, it's very, very huge, but that's how we look at it. They should both be separated, okay? And then that way, you know, when you have a tournament, you should have the tournament in the actual pro and with the summer circuit, because it is it's an event, okay? The live run should be something where everybody should posse up, where you can recruit your players, okay? And we feel that you should be able to have street cred with that, what you have in your street cred. When you have the street cred and you build your street cred up, you're going to get, you'll be able to evaluate in the live run, okay? So you're not going to be able to, so let's say you got this dude and he's a ball hog, you will get evaluated. You can evaluate that player, okay? Right. You'll be evaluated on that in the live run. And then you bring it over to the pro-am with the tournament. So when you have your squad, y'all go into a tournament. But the pro-am and everything is that's how, you know, that we look at it, because it's two different things. So just to get that straight, people, the live run is not pro, it's not, you know, don't get it, you know, mixed up with the pro-am. The live run is something that was incorporated in Live 10, which is actually is a EA original thing that was done in Live 10, but they used that in the dash and they added to the pro-am. But live run is not what pro-am is. Live run is something that was, that's something that is done from Live 10. The pro-am is something that's completed, which is real, was a real, real tournament. And the venues and everything that they incorporated, which is the real venues, which is excellent.
Yeah.
You got the stuff in Chicago. You got everything in Brooklyn. You got the Rucker. You got Venice Beach. You got the stuff in Seattle. So everything that's incorporated that they actually do in the pro-am at these venues, at these courts, that is the real deal, okay? And that cannot be said enough. You want authentic, and that's signature. So that's authenticity. So that is a beautiful thing. And they, and the sky's the limit with them with that. They can go so far, you know, with the pro-am aspect, because it is so deep. It is so deep. You know, and that's one mode that a lot of people really like to, you know, go further. I can talk about that for a long time. It's so deep, you know. Like, you know, and I'll, you know, let you take it after I say this part. It's like, how you feel. And a lot of people in our interviews might take this. You take your rising star, your creative player, okay? It should be incorporated with that. So
right.
You could bring that player over into the tournament. So you build that player up. It's the same thing now, but then you actually, in the rising star, how we feel it's going to be incorporated, is like you got to go through drills. Mm-hmm. You got to go through all that. You know, then you get evaluated in the live run, because you're going to do street pickup games before you actually go into the tournament, before you actually do the circuit. Right. The circuit is with, how it was with top-notch players. It's like, you know, if they don't be, you know, that tournament that they do, it's no joke. It's for real ballers.
Right.
So that's where it should be. They go that route where it's going to be sim, and you actually go into the tournament and you have your crew and you bring that over to the crew and you go against other crews, man, the sky's the limit for that mode. It's so much stuff that you can actually do with that mode. It's wow, I can go over hours with that.
Cool. You know what? You keep mentioning the, you know, you and the NLVC. Where can people go and get some of your stuff? Like, and listen to y'all talk about all of these things.
Well, we do our broadcast on YouTube. You can watch the videos on we have two channels. You can watch it on the Architect's channel. You can watch the whole video on his channel, or you can just watch it, because I put it in parts for me. So that'd be like, you know, I put it in parts for a reason, so you don't have to watch the whole thing. You just come back and watch the next part. But I put those parts in the playlist. So it's a playlist, and you can do that. If you want to, you can do it. You can go to the NLVC Twitter page. That link is up on the top. It's always pinned up at the top of our handle. It's at NLVC Committee. And you can go there, and then you can look at all the episodes in the playlist. We got everything down. So we already done did. We just got done doing episode 12.
Okay. Cool. Yes. Cool. That's what's up. All right, let's move on to this next topic before we get into some live run. But I feel like every time I bring up live to anybody, they always want to talk 2K versus live. What is your, how do you feel about the whole 2K versus live debate, argument, whatever?
How I feel about it is that people need to understand this. They need to stop. It's so premature. It doesn't make any sense.
Mm-hmm.
Let's break this down. What other sports game has competition? Think about that. There's none.
Yeah, I was about to say hockey doesn't really have it. Baseball, no.
No sport has no other game or no alternative that you can go to.
Mm-hmm.
Why would you want to have something that's an alternative to be the same as something else? Why would you want to do that? That's why it's called an option. That's why it's called an alternative. That's why it's called something different. You should be able to embrace competition because that's what you want. You don't want to have something where it's one that's just one game. Competition is good because it brings the masses out. It brings the max. It brings the max of potential of everybody out. Competition is a beautiful thing.
It is.
So, you know, as a community, okay, I can't speak for the 2K demographic. I can just speak for the live demographic. We don't go hard and just trying to bash 2K out like that. No, we're trying to get our game back to where it is. Your game is already established. We as a live community know that 2K is the standard right now. We know that. You know, we'll never say that that is not because mm-hmm. it is. We'll never deny that. But you have your fanboys, and you also have the ones that are in denial.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they will not acknowledge the competition. They'd rather just be like, well, blah this and blah that. Like a couple individuals today. You know, I'm like, well, why are you coming to me? Why are you coming to me in that manner? You know, because we're trying to, you know, we're praising competition. Or we're liking something that you might not like. That's why it's called you have an option. That's your choice on what you like.
Right.
You know? So I would never put down, the competition. I'm not. That's why that's why it's called an option. Now, are there certain things in 2K that there's certain, put it like this, and I say this a lot, and I say this. If this actually happened, and everybody would agree, if you took certain things from 2K and you took certain things from NBA Live, and you put them together, you got the ultimate basketball game.
Right.
But that's not going to happen.
Right.
So one game is going to give you something better than the other. That's why it's called a choice on what it is that you want, you know. So you have to actually, and you don't want to have something that's the same game. You can have the same element, which is going to be basketball. But that experience in that.
Head on over to part 4. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit that like button, and gladly put down your comments. If you haven't watched part 1 and part 2, gladly do so. Everything is in the description box. All right, y'all. Peace.